Welcome to this NewsPod edition of In the Hyperloop. I'm your host, Blake Annenberg, and we'll focus today on Arrivo. They have two huge announcements. First, being a quasi-Hyperloop test track and sled vehicle, but also plans to develop a new research center and test track. Arrivo is dedicated to vehicle and infrastructure systems focused on very high throughput with mini sleds for regional and super regional networks. Arrivo knows that the average highway can move around 2,000 to 3,500 vehicles per hour, but the Arrivo system is a dedicated roadway along that highway that could move 20,000 vehicles per hour. Before we dive in, just a quick reminder that In the Hyperloop relies on support from viewers like you. If you like what you see, please consider by supporting us with the link below. The goal of Arrivo is at full deployment, it could serve the whole urban corridor region along the Front Range of Colorado. Arrivo is developing a passively magnetically levitating sleighs. These sleighs are able to carry individual cars and trucks or cargo pallets or multiple passengers in distances no more than about 300 miles. The speed of these vehicles could go around 160 to 200 miles an hour. While sections could be elevated, others could be built in enclosed highway lanes. The goal of this is to reduce congestion and to connect existing transportation networks like airports. On top of that, Arrivo plans to grow their company in Colorado. They will open a test track in Commerce City, which is near Denver International Airport. And in 2018 alone, Arrivo expects to spend around $10 to $15 million by hiring 40 to 50 people and ramping up to 200 engineers and technicians in 2020, all in Colorado. Arrivo's fabrication and offices will be right on the test track that is currently vacant land near a toll road called E-470. There will also be a marketing and feasibility study with the Colorado Department of Transportation. Arrivo says they might be shovel ready by around January of next year for the facility, and systems level testing will be running next year with most of the technology development happening in Colorado. So the ethos of Arrivo is that people love their cars. They don't love traffic. This is what makes the Arrivo system compelling, because you don't have to give up your car. You can drive onto their sleigh, you can get dropped off, all by using autonomous vehicle technology. Arrivo is really focused on integrating on existing transportation systems as like a new transportation layer. First study even looks at integrating with Denver National Airport and possibly integrating with RTD, which is the regional transportation system here in Colorado. They market their system as one that can cover large distances between cities, but also get to your final urban destination. Arrivo is one platform, but with multiple product uses. First sleigh that you can drive your car onto. The second includes a pallet cargo moving vehicle. The third is like a super metro or a minibus that can move groups of people around. That last one would be great for bringing a bike on to complete the first and last mile of your journey. All these vehicles would share the same infrastructure and would eventually integrate with a local highway system. On the government side, the state of Colorado does have incentive packages that are site specific, but there are also local and state incentive that have been provided to the test site. The Colorado Department of Transportation has around $20,000 in rapid speed transportation money that is focused on Hyperloop technologies. Then, as Arrivo proves out their technology and with CDOT's feasibility study concluded, you know, in a couple years, there will be a discussion if there should be an infrastructure investment. At the press conferences last week in Colorado, Brogan Van Brogan, the CEO of Arrivo, said that they're just packaging a collection of technologies that already exist and that they're engineering them to be commercially focused to make them cheaper. The sled is propelled by electric linear motors, so there's no direct emission from the system. Also, that means that when the sleigh is in the system, the vehicle is powered by the system, so the sleigh doesn't have to stop to recharge. Then, at lower speeds, the sleigh will levitate. And by using the passive magnetic levitation, which allows for high speed, makes it for a safe, smooth ride, it'll feel pretty much like sitting in a chair. Also, these pods are not in a vacuum. So this is unlike Hyperloop Classic, which brings down the initial cost of building the system. A protective fence over the track, and they're also focusing on the information technology network that allows for the switching in Hyperloop track as well as going directly to their final destination. Prices for a ride on the Revo system will be around $15 for all modes of transportation on any sleigh. And the average commuter will go anywhere in Colorado in this region corridor around 20 minutes or less than that. This is the same pricing that Arrivo and CDOT are using for financial modeling for the E470 Beltway test track. Arrivo is confident that they can get their profit off this project. Not only will it make for to get around easier in the region, but also pay for itself. The testing phase for certification for the Revo system will take around 400 days, and that may start in 2019 or 2020. So it'll be a couple years of pure research and testing. If you want to learn more, check out arrivo-loop.com. Until then, see you in the Hyperloop.